everyone. Welcome to Anole Alley. In this episode, I'm going to introduce you guys to the others. As we venture into the alley today, we're going to meet the Anoles that live in the front yard, starting with this handsome fellow. This is a young male. I've discovered him living around the plants that I keep here on the front stoop. Also living in his territory is this cute little female. No, the plants aren't real. They're leftover silk plants from the winter season. There are real plants here, but this is the early spring, and not much has had the chance to grow back from their winter's sleep. Except the Anoles. The silk plants add just a little extra color. Above, however, is a natural plant and a beautiful native species called wisteria. It's a vine that produces lovely lavender or white blooms. We have both here. The fragrance is wonderfully sweet and refreshing. The female finds the cover of the Boston fir a good place to hang out, while the male hunts down on the elephant plant stand. I've nicknamed him the Doorman, simply because his territory and home base seem to be right here, near the front entrance to the house. In the spring, March through May, the Anoles all pick out the best spots to set up housekeeping. And here's another. And he's chosen this tall mimosa tree for his home. Meet Mo. Name for the tree, of course. He's also a gorgeous young male. And he looks a lot like Leo. But I know Leo well. And this lizard is way across the property, on the far side of the house, way away from the chain gang's territory. Leo still has not been seen in weeks. But for the past week, Mo has greeted me from the branches as I make my way around the corner of the house. This is perfect Anole habitat. The mimosa tree is a tropical species originating in the forest of the Far East, Asia. Though not a native species, it thrives here in the warm subtropics of the Gulf of Mexico. Mo defends his territory. Safe up here from most ground-based predators, he rests comfortably on a limb. He's got it made in the shade. Gosh, that does look fun. Swaying in the breeze. Yes, the front yard is home to many Anoles. And here, we find another large male. And I've named this one the Gatekeeper. This guy has made the area along the front walkway and the gate his property. And he wants you to know it, as well as all the other front yard Anoles. See this rosebush? I know for a fact it's over 20 years old. No kidding. This used to be my in-laws' home, and the rosebush was here and blooming while my husband and I were dating. That was back in 1984. The Gatekeeper also has a mate. However, they won't be together for that long, or as faithful to each other as human couples. But they will share the territory, protect it, and replenish it. And here, the female replenishes herself with a drink provided by an early morning rain shower as she laps the water droplets from the leaves of the clematis, the vine producing those pretty purple flowers. Also, notice how she's using her prehensile tail to secure herself. Over in the flower pots, on the front stoop, the female companion to the doorman seems to have found something of interest. Whoa, something made her dive for cover. I think she may have been reacting to a bird flying close by. Or she could have been startled by an appearance from the doorman. He creeps over, moving closer and closer. A few moments later, the two of them meet in one of the flower pots. I move closer and find them both together, the male gently embracing the female. Together, they proclaim to all the other Anolis that they are now the It Couple, the king and queen of the front stoop. They're so cute. They seem to be telling the whole world, speaking volumes without any words. And this is the message they were sending. Isn't it adorable? The most adorable thing in my front yard. A tiny baby Anoli. While who I suspect are its parents watch. The tiny baby Anoli sets off to explore its new world. I love seeing the babies. It means that the Anolis have the perfect environment here. This little fellow may hang around with the adults for a little while, but as it grows, it will soon have to find its own space in the alley. And that concludes our tour of the front yard and our visit with its many residents, the other Anolis. Until next time.